you keep doing that, keep switching. Keep doing that until the parent is gone.
Or tell you see if the person is breathing by itself.
As I said, for CPR, very, very unlikely. You're just gonna keep doing CPR.
It can happen, right? If the person.
0.1 chance. Yes, it can happen, but 0.1. Notice that I never teach you to assess breathing while you're doing CPR. The reason is because the chance of that happening, the person wake breathing, is so slim that we don't even check the breathing. Notice you don't do CPR, and then after a certain amount of cycles, oh, let me assess breathing. We don't even do that. Because the chance of the person breathing is so slim, we don't.
But I noticed that you're teaching us that when you blow inside and you look at the chest, right?
Yes.
See if the air is there. But while you're looking at it, and then when you see the person stop, you should not stop, you keep going.
Okay, first of all, you're not going to see the person breathing. And second of all, when you're doing that, your breathing and the chest rise is rising because you're breathing into it, not because the person is breathing at all.
Okay.
The only assessment is when you do this. But notice, when we're doing CPR, we never assess breathing. We don't want to waste time. The chance of them breathing on their own is so slim that it's not part of the technique. We don't teach you to assess breathing while you're doing CPR. There's no point. There's like a 0.1 chance of them breathing on their own.
And let's say if you do that, right? You do that, and then the person starts to wake up and start.
Nope, that's not going to happen. Okay, so let me just tell you right now, instead of confusing you by saying 0.1 chance, zero. Just remember what I said. There's zero chance of that happening.
So why are we doing
it? We're doing it because we're keeping them viable. Again, we're doing CPR because we want to squeeze the heart, keep the blood flowing, and by keeping the blood flowing and keep giving the person air,
they won't suffer
we're
brain damage.
Keeping him viable so that when the paramedics come, they will help.
Could you say that the reason why I asked this question, because I only see in the movie, right? And in the movie,
I come
back again, which that people that been drawing in the water,
no.
When they do that, the guy start to move or the water start to come out, they stop.
Okay,
that's
so
why.
Some people say, well, I saw on YouTube, that's what happened. Those are fake videos.
Okay.
Maybe they just do it so that they become popular, okay? But those are fake videos. If it's a real, true situation, they won't wake up.
Really, yeah?
Yeah, because I saw one video, she's giving him CPR, and I was like, oh, I feel much better. And they got like maybe 20,000 views.
Wow.
Yeah, but that's, I as soon as I saw that, I knew that was fake. But for somebody who's not trained in CPR, who's not an instructor, they may be impressed and say, wow,
well, wait, I impressed.
He did
that,
he did such a good job, no, that's fake.
Okay.
That's not
so
fake.
So really CPR,
once a person needs CPR, you're doing a CPR, you're gonna do it until the paramedics come.
Wow.
The waking up is like, just consider it zero. There's zero chance the person will breathe on the moment.
Okay, so what happens if you do a CPR, you get tired, you cannot do no more, what happened to the person?
Okay, so surprisingly enough, if you get tired, you are allowed to just stop. But don't walk away. Okay, so in other words, don't start CPR, and then, oh, I'm too tired, go to McDonald's. Okay, don't do that. You must stay in the area.
They
stay in the area until the paramedics come.
Yeah, do your best to leave.
But like I see in the movie too, right? Like they do CPR, and then they see that the guy never wake up. He said, okay, done, I'm done. I stop because he never wake up.
No.
No, right?
You can stop if you're tired. Okay, surprisingly enough, you can't.
But
because if you're tired, you just cannot do stop because
you think
he's
dead.
Okay. Okay? Very, very important. Do not stop because he's dead, because it's not up to you to determine he's dead. It's up to you to keep him viable. And then it's up to the paramedics or even the doctors to assess whether he's so dead that he's beyond help.
Good.
All right, so as I said, Tom and David, you guys want to move?
Can we go on the same unit or?
No.
Oh, David, you're going to stay. Okay. Tom, I want you to stay, David. Just try to remember. So decide among yourself who's the first birth leader. And the first birth leader will start the compression. So 30 compressions. And remember, you gotta count out loud and then keep track of how many cycles. Let me count. I think you guys need help to coordinate.